The Oakland Athletics have been pathetic the past two seasons, and that's the simplest way to put it, as after they missed the playoffs in 2021, going 86-76, we saw them decide to, instead of spending money like normal MLB teams do and extending their best players, they decided, why don't we just give them up for nothing and then just continue to suck? So of course, we saw a fire sale in that year's offseason that saw names like Matt Olson, Matt Chapman, Sean Manaea, and Chris Bassett all get traded away, along with Mark Canna leaving in free agency, along with key reliever Jack Deacon. This team was as bare bones can get, and they only had two bright spots, I would say, in catcher Sean Murphy and starting pitcher Frankie Montas. But one more thing would happen in 2021, as the Athletics would draft infielder out of the University of Virginia Zack Gelof in the second round of the amateur draft with the 60th pick. In 2022, the A's would do just about as good as everyone expected, as they went 60-102 and were the laughing stock of the MLB, as they had just about five good players in Sean Murphy, Seth Brown, Frankie Montas, and AJ Puk. But luckily for the Athletics, they dealt away Frankie Montas, and he's been horrible since for the Yankees, not even pitching in 2023, and posting above a 6 ERA in 2022, so good on them for that, I guess. But following the 2022 season, the Athletics would do their best to ship out two of those good players in Sean Murphy to the Atlanta Braves for nothing notable, and AJ Puk to the Marlins for JJ Bleday, which might actually be a decent trade for the A's, so good on them, but it left the roster once again looking extremely awful for the upcoming 2023 season. But in the minors, Zack Gelof had jumped all the way up to AAA by the end of the 2022 season, and had posted a triple slash that consisted of a 270 batting average, 352 on-base percentage, 463 slugging percentage, and an 815 OPS, along with 18 homers and 37 extra base hits in total, and saw him jump up to the A's third best prospect before the 2023 season. The A's would regress following their further destruction of this team, as on July 14th they were an astonishing 25-68 and were projected to be one of the top 5 worst teams of all time, and that is when they decided to call up their top 3 prospect in Zack Gelof, who had been tearing it up in the minors, posting 36 extra base hits that included 12 homers and a triple slash that consisted of a 304 batting average, 401 on base percentage, 529 slugging percentage, and a 930 OPS. And since being called up, Zack Gelof has basically been the only bright spot in the Oakland A's pathetic 2023 season so far, as he's hit 8 homers along with 10 other extra base hits, and has a 277 batting average, 336 on base percentage, and a 624 slugging percentage, which gives him an OPS of 960 and an OPS plus of 168. Since being called up, Gelof leads the American League in extra base hits at 18, and since July 28th, he leads the American League at homers at 7. And this has all happened in 27 games, so yes, you could say he might just be due a hot start in his career, and he'll return to Earth, and yes, I agree, he probably won't hold this level of play his whole career, most likely, but it's not like this isn't manageable for the rest of the year, at least. And it's not like he's playing way better than expected, as on Baseball Savant, his expected batting average is at 257, which is 20 points lower, and his expected slug is at 499, which is 125 points lower, but taking 25 points off his on-base percentage and 125 off his slug, he would still have an 815 OPS, which would still tie him for 6th among primary second basemen, and above names like Bryson Stott, Gleyber Torres, Whit Merrifield, and Jonathan India. And along the way, Gelof has even made a little history, becoming the first player in the modern era to hit 8 homers and steal 6 bases in his first 25 games, which displays his power-speed combo he has, so I'd say that's pretty good for a rookie, but the side Gelof needs to work on is his defense. So far this year, Gelof is worth negative 3 DRS and negative 0.2 defensive war, and having watched him in a handful of games, I can say he doesn't look very comfortable at second base, and he doesn't seem to have a fit for the position quite yet, but this could come with time, and I think it most likely will, as Gelof was more of a third baseman in the minors, and is just now starting at second base, so I'd say give him some time before labeling him as a bad defender. In the barren wasteland that is the 2023 Oakland Athletics, Gelof has exploded onto the scene as something to be excited about out in Oakland, and I think we could see Gelof turn into one of the better second basemen in all of baseball in the coming seasons. If you guys did enjoy today's video, please make sure to like and subscribe, it would be very much appreciated, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.